Yeah. We keep refreshing Twitter just like you do because this is the story everybody's tracking. It is understandable when we look at what Tavares brings, the captain of the New York Islanders. This is a UFA that we have been projecting to this day for so long. And with July 1st looming, it's significant to take a look at just why this date is important, particularly for the Islanders, Dano.
Well, obviously, midnight tonight, he has to agree with the Islanders to get that extra year, that eighth year where he can't get from other teams. That's the obvious point, but we all wait in anticipation, and we're talking hockey still. Tony, these things do drag on. We know it, but John Tavares has earned that right to really sit down, think about his decision. Everybody thinks it's taken forever, but I understand this is an important decision. He's played 9 years on the island. Do you want to finish what you started there? I mean, he seems like a very loyal guy. But on the other hand, when you get presented with all these other offers, the money's going to be great wherever he goes. So Everybody looks at every dollar. I think for John Tavares, it's not that because it's going to be astronomical. We know that. He's be a very lucrative contract, and he's earned that from the production he's had in those first 9 years. And I also do understand, for a great player like Tavares, the frustration. You've won one playoff round in 9 years, and at some point in your career, you want to win.
Mm-hmm.
Now, does he feel with new management, a Stanley Cup coach on the island? Well, yeah, I want to be part of the solution, and I think I can be revitalized as far as fresh in my mind that we have an opportunity. They will do enough to make us contender. And again, I go to the Vegas Golden Knights. Look no further. Every team that has some talent, has players, add pieces here and there, is a contender. The Islanders could be that team. I know they gave up a plethora of goals, but things can change in a hurry, as we know, as we've seen in the league with the competitive balance throughout. And those are all the options he has to weigh. The decision he's making with, whether it's San Jose or Toronto or staying with the Islanders or possibly the Boston Bruins, careful when you pick your poison. Doesn't mean you're going to win for sure. We know that, right? I mean, obviously, there's no guarantees because there's only a select few teams we know that are even going to be in the playoffs because it changes year to year. But he's be weighing all his options of what team gives him the best opportunity to win. That's what I think it's about, basically, what it comes down to for John Tavares. He's starting a family, getting married in the offseason as well. So living and where he's going to live for the next 7 years, if it's not with the Islanders,
right.
Along the way, all these things come into the factor. And the fact that if it was Toronto, well, whatever the money is and tax ramifications and, you know, you see all that on social media, that, well, it's, it comes out the annual average of salary is a lot less here than it is here. Well, if you happen to go to Toronto, you know, he's going to say Canadian Tire, I'm John Tavares, and I like them, and he's going to make another $20 million. Let's not forget that, because Canada is, or whatever company it is.
You bet.
Canada, so he will make it up from that perspective. But I just think it's more about winning for John Tavares. Obviously, I'm an old school guy. He seems loyal. I would like to see him stay on Long Island from the standpoint that I've been here a long time. I know it's been a lot of frustration. Can I be that leader? Can I even elevate my game more? And I'm not talking just about offensive production. I'm talking about galvanizing the guys around me, making them better, as long as management adds the right pieces, that we can be a contender as soon as next year, if not next year, the year after, and I want to be part of that.
And you made the point that he led them to a playoff round win. That was a couple years ago against Florida in the first round. That was a Florida team that won its division. As we look at their projected forward lines, if he stays put, the what-if game is fun because it gives us a sense of what things might look like. You made the point, it's a different feel on Long Island now with Lou Lamoriello, with Barry Trotz, the cup winner. How about the personnel they have and projecting forward? You know, in fact, Lou Lamoriello has those same three rings you have.
Yes.
There's a lot of credibility with that. And Barry Trotz, the ring probably is still being designed, but it's going to be gaudy and beautiful, and he and his Caps earned it. What about the future?
First off, it gives them instant respect, and that's what you've heard ever since Lou Lamoriello came on board, as well as getting current Stanley Cup coach.
That's right.
In
Barry Trotz.
In Long Island.
And, yeah.
And that gives you respect right away. Now, you have to have the roster on the ice and players, and there's some holes to fill, like a lot of teams, but certainly in New York Islanders, the defensive deficiencies were astronomical. The goaltending certainly has to be rectified, something I'm sure they've been working on for the last month, ever since Lou was hired as general manager of the New York Islanders, has full autonomy. They look at all those things, but I'm sure they presented to John Tavares we can plug these holes because you've got Anders Lee, we've got Josh Bailey, we've got maybe the brightest young star and reigning Calder Trophy winner on our roster that, you know, he won games single-handedly. He's a game changer.
What a player.
I mean, you'd think that has to make Tavares excited. You would hope, Lou, I always say, one thing he did do is good working with politicians, everything, that this rink will get built sooner than later. Mm-hmm. They're going to play some more games back in their old barn, Long Island. It's been renovated in Uniondale there, the Coliseum. So, you know, there's a lot of good things still, and they have diehard fans that want to see this team get back to the glory days, or at least have some excitement, have some hope again. So these are all the things going on with John Tavares, but he's got good players surrounded to play with, mm-hmm. certainly. It's not the scoring. They scored plenty of goals, and he still put up 87 points. So whoever he plays with there, where he had success with Anders Lee or Josh Bailey, whoever it may be, those pieces are there. It's about, I'm sure he's concerned about, are we going to add a defenseman? And certainly you can't win without a goaltender that gives you a chance 80% of the time or every night to win a hockey game where they didn't get consistent goaltending, as we know.
And Lou understands that. We think about the turnaround in Toronto. He went Freddie Anderson 5x5, and we saw how important that was. Marty Brodeur with the Devils. Lou is in control.